All right, some real quick tips and tricks for our trig functions and angles. Okay, number one, on your calculator, you gotta make sure that you're in the right mode, okay? To switch between degrees and radians, there's a button on your TI 83 or 83 plus that says mode. Make sure you're in the right mode for this, whether you're dealing with radians or degrees. If you're not, it's just gonna be trouble, so get used to figuring that out. Number two, the ratios, the sine, cos, or tan ratios, they don't change depending on which way you are messing with this whole trig ratio function thing. They don't change depending on how you measure. Number three, 180 degrees equals pi radians. Okay, what that means is that if you go around a circle to 180 degrees, you've gone pi distance. Not pi distance, that's pi radians. That 3.14 radians. If you go all the way around, you are at 2 pi radians. Okay? So that is like 6.28 radians estimate. Okay? For preciseness, you want to just leave it as pi as much as you can. Okay? We'll leave it at that for now. Suppose I wanted to find out how many degrees are in one radian? Have we talked about what radians are? Yes, okay. How many degrees in one radian? No, I'll just leave it like how it was before. I said leave it at pi, right? So at pi radians, what I'm going to do is divide it by pi alone, just pi. Okay? But I got to do it to both sides. So I will get 180 degrees divided by 3.14-ish, and that'll equal, those will cancel out, to 1 over 1 radians. Okay, well, that's 1 radian. What this ratio works out to be is 57.29578 degrees, because the degrees is still here, it didn't go anywhere, equals 1 radian, okay? Now, what that means, does that make any sense? Yeah, that makes sense. Oh yeah, okay, so what this means, I have to just have these brain farts here. If we go up from the initial angle to this thing here, this angle will be this many degrees, okay? And this, on an angle of this many degrees right here, the length of this arc will be 1 radian. Okay? And remember, there would be 2 radian somewhere in there, there would be 3 radian, and by the end of here you'd be at 3.14. radian, which is pi radian, at exactly this line here. Okay, so that's how this all comes to be. The other thing, of course, is this. It doesn't. When we write degrees, we write that little dot. But when we write radians, we don't have to write radian. It's assumed. Naturally, lazy math people will assume that if you have like pi over 4. As an angular measurement, it's assumed to be radians whether it's written there or not. Okay, it'll always be assumed to be radians. So if you ever see something like that measuring, you know it's radians. Let's see if there's something else I wanted to. Yeah, that's about it. But if you want to distinguish degrees, you have to put the little circle on there. Okay, but I do not have to write. I don't have to write the word radians. It's just assumed to be there. Okay. Tips and tricks. Move on to the next vid.